Good morning, and welcome to the Catholic Church of St. Mark. Please take this time to silence your cell phones, and as you do, let us rise as we begin our celebration.
He finds so many ways to reach out to us, even when we are not even ready for him. That shows his love for us. Beloved, as we come before our Lord and Father to offer these sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are always Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you will be magnified in our living and our dying. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are salvation for all God's people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us all our sins and bring us life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
To God in the highest, let all earth be still people of goodwill. We praise you, we love you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty,
see you on earth.
God who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor. Grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
So we have the children liturgy. Please come forward. So hello. So today we reflect more about God's kingdom, and everybody have a place. Anytime you come, he's ready for you. So we are going to learn more about how God wants everybody to be part of his kingdom. The Lord bless you all in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. According to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. And after agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 and did likewise. Going out at 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started at 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. When the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous?" Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
So we thank the Lord for today, giving us a bright day and bringing us together. It is by His grace that we move and have our being. As we gather today, we gather to listen to Him. In the first reading, Isaiah calls us to seek the Lord while He is near and to forsake our wicked ways. He reminds us that God's thoughts and ways transcend our own, just as the heavens are higher than the earth. This passage invites humility and recognition of our limited perspective before divine wisdom. The gospel presents the idea of showing generosity and grace even when it is unexpected. It also illustrates God's unfathomable generosity, where all workers, regardless of when they arrive, receive the same reward. In the background of today's gospel lies Jesus' parable of salvation history. The parable illustrates the Lord's generosity, where both the Israelites and the Gentiles are offered the same blessings, emphasizing God's ways are beyond human comprehension. In this parable, the grumblings of the workers of the first hour are enhanced. They are the parallel image of the elder brother of the parable of the prodigal son. God holds all wealth, and He is generous and gracious to all. That is an obvious message through this parable. Those called and chosen at the last have access to God's kingdom, just as those called and chosen at the start of the day. God's grace to those who are faithful is a key lesson here. The vineyard is the new world, the world that God Himself wants His Son to establish. Jesus wants you to know that the landowner is God, and His vineyard is very special. The landowner hires workers into His vineyard, whether He needs them or not. He hires them, and He brings them back. And that's the first clue about this lovely parable. The theme underlines the value of extending kindness to others without a fixed set of conditions. It suggests that everyone deserves respect and consideration, irrespective of their roles. God's vineyard is for all the children of the world. The Lord gives us a new world, a new kind of living, a new value system, not based on fair or unfair, rather based on His unconditional love. Isaiah's message of God's transcendent thoughts finds its echo here. Just as the landowner's ways surpass the laborer's expectations, God's mercy extends our understanding. Both passages invite us to release our rigid notions of fairness and instead embrace God's vast, compassionate perspective. If you understand that part, then you know this is indeed a lovely parable. Why? Because Matthew puts it in a very interesting way. Do you notice the hours we are told when He goes out? Dawn, the time that the Jews gathered for prayer in the synagogue. The second time is 9 o'clock, when they come back from their chores and enter the holy place and pray. The third time is at noon. Jesus begins His terrible ordeal, when he's condemned to death and led to the mountain at noon. And the fourth time is at 3 p.m. You all know Jesus died at 3 p.m. on the cross. And the last hour he went out was at 5 o'clock. That is the time Pilate sends out men to bury Jesus when he died on the cross. Beloved, work is over at 6. It means that the landowner has gone out 5 times. The 5 times, beloved in Christ, could represent the 5 holy wounds of Christ. In Catholic tradition, the 5 sacred wounds are the 5 piercing wounds that Jesus Christ suffered during his crucifixion. They comprise the nail holes in his right and left hands, and also in his right and left feet, and also the final one will be the hole in his torso from the piercing of the spear. So that's the 5 wounds. We also have wounds like the crown of thorns and the scourging at the pillar. They are not part of the 5 wounds. They are some kind of wounds Jesus sustained. We should know that the medieval popular piety focused upon the 5 wounds associated directly with Christ's crucifixion. That is why we talk about the 5 wounds created by the nail, so not that of the head and also that of the scourging of the pillar. However, these are all devotional things that people do anyway. But we focus more on the 5 wounds of Christ, that is at the crucifixion itself. Beloved in Christ, so this parable of the vineyard is indeed the prophetic image of the people of Israel in the Old Testament and now of the new people of God, born from the wounded side of Christ. According to St. Origen, and I quote, "From the wound in Christ's side has come forth the church, and he has made her his bride." St. Matthew is very, very clever. He's saying that it is not just a story about hiring hands. It is God preparing his garden. His garden that will be the new kingdom. That is why St. Paul's words in the second reading resonate with a profound devotion to Christ. He expresses his desire to honor Christ, whether through life or through death, because that will be our ticket to that new kingdom which God is building for us. Paul's eagerness to serve Christ, irrespective of life or death, goes beyond personal gain, embodying the essence of selfless dedication. "It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you." Let's get our mind to when Jesus started calling them. Or to when the landowner started calling them. He went to call them. Nobody came by themselves. So just think about the wider aspect of this parable. In fact, in all the parables Jesus gave, and even Jesus' messages in the gospel, beloved in Christ, you will never finish exhausting their meanings. The more you discover, the more you find out there's even more to be discovered. That is why it's always refreshing to always be in tune with Scripture, have time for Scripture, and meditate on Scripture. You will keep loving it. You can be reading the same thing all the time, but I tell you, you keep discovering something else. And that is the Jesus, the God whom you and I are serving. And we are very grateful that today he uses this opportunity to show us his love again to all of us. Beloved in Christ, the overreaching message of the parable of the laborers in today's gospel is the bountiful grace we receive from the Eucharist. God pours out his benevolent gifts to undeserving sinners, not in exchange for any effort on our part, but rather as expression of his grace. As we ponder on today's readings, we are again called to humility and trust. The divine economy of grace challenges us to let go of our limited sense of justice and instead embrace the boundless
generosity of our Creator. May the good Lord give us the grace always to do His will. May He bless us all. Amen. Shall we please rise and profess our faith in God? I believe in one God. We come before our loving God and present our petitions.
For Pope Francis, along with our bishops and pastors, that they will always be signs of God's presence among us as they preach the gospel of life and love, we pray. For our leaders, that they will be generous in forgiving others and leading our global community to lasting peace, we pray. For all priests on this priesthood Sunday, especially for those in our diocese and our pastor, Father Eric, along with a greater response to the call of the vocation to the priesthood, we pray. For all migrants and refugees, on this World Day of Migrants and Refugees, that they will find hospitality and compassion as they find a new place they can call home, we pray. For our parish community, that we will exercise the kind of generosity called for this today's gospel and become a place where generous stewardship is practiced beyond measure, we pray. For all the sick in our parish, in our families, and in our parish book of intercessions, that they will know recovery from illness and relief from pain, we pray. For those who have died, those most recently in our parish, and those who remember this weekend, Philip and Philomena Calabres, that they will be welcomed into the everlasting peace of heaven, we pray.
We also pray for Patricia, our proud church member, whom we lost recently, who has gone to her maker. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us ask our Blessed Mother to intercede for us. Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
O God of boundless love and mercy, listen to the prayer of your people. Make us generous stewards of the abundant gifts given to us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, and you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, A pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, and he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, with the glorious martyrs, with Saint Mark, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope Barry, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, get yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants, Philip and Philomena Calabres, whom we offer this Mass, and also us pray for the soul who were united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our only body after the parting of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. When you wipe away every faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your word, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death to life. Gently arise me and heal my weary soul.
shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. You have served me a banquet of love in the face of hatred, crowning me. Thank you.
pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
It is with some sadness that we have to announce the passing of Patricia McMicken, a longtime choir member, and I believe one time the choir director here. She died Thursday. Funeral will be September 30th at 2 p.m. More information as we get closer. For this coming week, our daily masses are Tuesday and Thursday at 8:30 and Wednesday at 7 p.m., preceded by the rosary at 6:30. The religious formation sessions for elementary, middle school, and high school begin this Sunday, the 24th, in case you want to know the date. Elementary will start from 12:30 to 2. Middle and high school is 6 to 8 p.m. Sacramental Preparation Parent Meeting for First Reconciliation and Holy Communion is this coming Tuesday at 6. For the Diocesan Eucharistic Pilgrimage to the Basilica in Washington on Saturday the 21st is closed. We have now started a standby list. If you signed up and cannot go, please let us know so that we can fill the seat. Ms. Elise Ugart is a canonist and a defender of the bond for the diocese and will present an informational workshop on the annulment process this next Saturday, September 30th at 10 a.m. here at St. Mark. All are welcome, especially individuals considering annulments or who have questions about how the Catholic Church conducts these proceedings. And you can contact Sherry, our secretary, for more information. The Knights of Columbus Pumpkin Patch is October 8th for unloading. So we have 1,400 pumpkins coming, all different sizes, all different shapes, and one that will fit your body to remove from the truck. Help is needed on offloading the truck, and also to sell the pumpkins from October 9th to the 31st, from 12 to 8 p.m. Proceeds go to church activity. The annual Eucharistic procession on the Virginia Beach Boardwalk will be conducted on Sunday, October 8th, with Mass at Star of the Sea, right there on Pacific Avenue, at 12 p.m., followed by a procession to 24th Street, where there'll be adoration and then a return to the Star of the Sea for benediction. The roof. The latest information we have is that the last three trucks will arrive Tuesday, full of pieces and parts, and they will go next to those big blue covers in the back, and work will start during this week. Young married couples, they have a meeting scheduled for September 29th, that's Friday, from 5:30 to 7:30. And if you go into the Great Hall, you'll see a display of all the ministries that are staffed here to assist the parish in performing its functions. And we would like your help, obviously, to help us serve others. Thank you.
So we pray for our parents and guardians today as they are the first catechists for our children. Shall we please rise? As we begin our religious formation sessions, we remind parents and guardians that you are entrusted with a special role and responsibility from your child's baptism in the formation, in the forming of your children in the faith. God our Father, let your peace settle within the hearts of these mothers, fathers, and guardians. Give them strength and wisdom as they care for their children. Show them how to raise their families with patience and tenderness. Give them strength during the times of greatest difficulty and help them recognize the little joys that are part of each day. May they grow in wisdom, understanding, and grace. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, who is one with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. The love and serve the Lord one another.
Thanks be to God.
To us, you who say, I will not forget you. Be with us, you who say, do not be afraid. Take hold of us, our hearts, our minds, our being. Make us your own. Now is the time. Spirit of love, crush the pain of hatred. Spirit of hope, stand before our eyes. Spirit of light, dance within our darkness. Make us your own. Now is the time. Come to us, you who say, I will not forget you. Be with us, you who say, do not be afraid. Take hold of us, our hearts, our minds, our whole being. Make us your own. Now is the time. Spirit of peace, silence tongues of anger. Spirit of life, break the chains of death. Spirit of joy, overcome our sadness. Make us your own. Now is the time. Come to us, you who say, I will not forget you. Be with us, you who say, do not be afraid. Take hold of us, our hearts, our minds, our whole being. Now is the time. Spirit of faith, rise above us doubting. Spirit of truth, save us from our lies. Spirit of God, walk among your people. Make us your own. Now is the time. Come to us, you who say, I will not forget you. Be with us, you who say, do not be afraid.